the United States and Germany were the pioneers of aircraft during World War II, including innovations with an incredible arsenal of weapons systems. As the war drew close to the end, the Luftwaffe launched the first jet-powered bomber, the Arado Ar 234, in a last effort to turn the tide of the war. The Americans immediately began to work on a bomber with similar capabilities. The B-45 Tornado was produced by North American Aviation, but the war ended before the prototype was tested in combat. Still, it would eventually achieve several firsts during its operational service. The B-45 was the first four-engine jet bomber to fly, and the first to refuel in mid-air. It was also the first jet bomber to enter service with the U.S. Air Force, and the first capable of carrying a nuclear weapon. Incidentally, it was also the first jet bomber to be successfully shot down by a jet fighter. A World War II initiative. Air dominance became extremely important during the various fronts of World War II. Without valuable air support, infantry formations and armored units were often unable to advance through enemy territory without suffering heavy casualties. Besides their dogfighting capabilities, aircraft were also used to drop bomb loads over static and moving objects, spot enemy divisions, pillboxes, secret facilities, and many other valuable tactical objectives in their reconnaissance roles. The astonishing development and evolution from the clunky and primitive aircraft that saw service during the 4 years of World War I was a combat changer. As with armored vehicles and tanks, warfare was never the same after aircraft saw an immense evolution following World War I. German theorists prioritized speed, momentum, and a never-before-seen scale of continuous and unstoppable offensives. They baptized this new doctrine as the Blitzkrieg. Nevertheless, the German technological superiority considerably diminished as the war raged on. The escalating destruction of German factories and economic facilities caused by Allied bombings took a hefty toll across the country. Additionally, the Reich's enemies began developing aircraft that would exceed the performance of many produced by the Luftwaffe, and they would not show mercy until Germany surrendered. One of the Reich Air Ministry's last attempts to support the war effort and try to change its outcome was to direct their scarce resources into the production of jet-powered bomber aircraft that could deliver its payloads before being shot down. The Arado Ar 234 Blitz eventually came to be, and it was the first jet-powered bomber produced in the world. Fortunately for the Allies, only a handful of Ar 234s were produced because of the deteriorating Reich's economy. The few that were thrown into duty served mainly on reconnaissance roles, and the U.S. Army Air Corps was able to catch a breath. An American response. After the German Arado Ar 234 Blitz wreaked havoc in the skies, the United States War Department required an aircraft that could withstand it. In October of 1944, the Army Air Forces issued a mission need statement to American manufacturers for a bomber similar to the Arado. Besides its jet propulsion requirement, the light bomber aircraft required a gross weight between 80,000 and 200,000 pounds. The outnumbered Luftwaffe was about to collapse under American, British, and Soviet air superiority, but it still posed a threat to the slow-moving 500-plus bomber formations that were decimating German cities. The Allied forces were about to break into the heart of Germany, and anti-aircraft fire was rampant over the skies. A countermeasure was pressing, and the development of the latest American aircraft was accelerated. Of all the manufacturers that submitted designs, North American Aviation was granted the contract after presenting the NA-130 prototype. While its design was being further developed, World War II came to an end. Hundreds of unfinished projects were canceled while the focus turned to rebuild Europe. Still, the light bomber project was only momentarily halted. Europe was now divided into two blocks. The Soviet Union distanced itself from the rest of the continent by creating a political boundary known as the Iron Curtain. This gave way to the Cold War and the nuclear age. While the Soviets began to develop their own atomic arsenal, the United States shifted its war priorities to develop aircraft capable of swiftly delivering atomic bomb loads in the case of emergencies. By mid-1946, the long-range strategic bombers that the U.S. was planning to operate by the end of the year suffered unexpected setbacks. The delay of the Boeing XB-47 and the Martin XB-48 would now expose the country and its allies to a potential Soviet attack. This holdup favored North American Aviation. On January 2, 1947, the U.S. Air Force signed a contract with the company to immediately produce their oft-delayed aircraft. It was dubbed the B-45 Tornado. An interim aircraft. The B-45 was planned to be an interim aircraft before more powerful bombers entered service. The initial plan was to equip more than six bombing and reconnaissance groups composed of B-45s, but the numbers were later reduced due to production issues. According to the aircraft's official specification sheet, the B-45's primary mission would be, quote, the destruction by bombs of land or naval material objectives. The aircraft would be commanded by a crew of four consisting of the pilot, co-pilot slash radio operator, bombardier slash navigator, and a tail gunner. State-of-the-art additions would enhance the B-45. Some of these were, quote, thermal anti-icing, cabin pressurization, heating and cooling, ejection-type seats for pilot and co-pilot, and emergency escape hatches for navigator and tail gunner. communication equipment, emergency flight controls, and instruments were installed at the co-pilot station. Additionally, a Type E-4 autopilot, bombing navigation radar, and an A-1 fire control system were installed as standard equipment. As a light bomber, the B-45 only packed two 50-caliber machine guns in its tail. However, it could carry a 22,000-pound bomb load, including nuclear weaponry. It was the first engine aircraft to do so. The aircraft was powered by four General Electric J-47 engines that provided 6,000 pounds of thrust. It could also reach speeds of up to 570 miles per hour, with an estimated range of 1,000 miles and a service ceiling of 37,500 feet. In March of 1947, the B-45 flew for the first time at the North American facilities in Inglewood, California. Test pilots George Krebs and Paul Brewer reported several technical issues, but they were mostly ignored due to the project's urgency. By mid-1948, the U.S. Air Staff began to openly question the value of the B-45, and President Harry S. Truman's budget cuts led to a reduction from the initially intended 200 B-45s. North American ended up building 142 B-45 bombers, of which the majority were the standard B-45A variant. 33 were B-45Cs, configured for high-altitude photo reconnaissance. This model became the first multi-engine jet aircraft to successfully refuel in mid-air. 10 were RB-45Cs, modified with wingtip fuel tanks for long-range operations. The B-45B variant, which was to be equipped with a radar-guided fire control system, did not secure an order and was scrapped. When the Korean War broke out in 1950, the U.S. Air Force was ready to send the B-45 Tornado for actual combat testing. The expected long-range bombers were still under production, and the B-45 was the best the Air Force could offer. It would not disappoint. Going to war. During the Korean War, aircraft was essential to push back the invading North Koreans and Chinese to the 38th parallel. The B-45 was used from the beginning with its bomber and reconnaissance variants. As NATO forces led by the U.S. made their way through the South Korean landscape, the B-45 was critical in identifying enemy strongholds within mountains and valleys. The B-45s also dropped their heavy ordnance with escort fighters over demilitarized areas during the first NATO offensive of 1950, and the numerous B-45 formations, which could suddenly carry out nuclear strikes, became an effective deterrent against the Soviet Union's nuclear threats. Still, the B-45's insufficient 50-caliber machine guns made them extremely vulnerable to enemy interceptor aircraft such as the lethal Soviet MiG-21. On December 4, 1950, the first interception of a jet bomber by a MiG-15 jet fighter took place over Chinese territory. Soviet pilot Alexander F. Andreano shot down a B-45C reconnaissance aircraft piloted by Captain Charles McDonough, Air Force Intelligence Officer John Lovell, co-pilot Captain Jules E. Young, and Lieutenant James D. Pacucci. Only McDonough was able to parachute from the aircraft. Still, he was taken prisoner by Soviet or Chinese forces and never seen again. The nature of the reconnaissance mission over China and the involvement of an intelligence officer in the operation have not been revealed to this day. A few years later, American Major Lou Carrington and his crew of the 91st Recon Wing performed the first non-stop trans-Pacific flight aboard a B-45C and won the McKay Trophy. They flew from Alaska to Japan in almost 10 hours, refueling twice during the journey. Colonel Harold R. Hal Austin, assigned to the 324th SRS of the 91st SRW, was selected to transition into the B-45 Tornado in the early 1950s. He picked up a brand new model and learned to fly it on his own. He quickly realized that it was basically a World War II airplane with several limitations, but by 1952, he had changed his tune. After adding tail guns to it and learning how to manage its engines, he proudly called the Tornado, quote, a great pilot's airplane.